today's video, I'll be explaining the ISO, the shutter speed, and the aperture, or f-stop as it's known, and the importance of all three and how you can use them in your camera to start shooting. Let's start off with ISO. ISO allows the camera to take in more light digitally when you're using it. So what I mean by that is if you're in a situation with low light and you need more light, and let's say your f-stop and your shutter are all the way down and your aperture is all the way open, and you still need more light, the ISO helps your camera bring in more light digitally. Now, the downsides to that are the higher the ISO you go, the more grain and noise you're gonna get in your image. The lower the ISO you have, the less grain, the less noise that you're gonna get in your image. Also, each camera has its native ISO setting. Native ISO setting means that you set the camera, for example, to 850 ISO. That's what your camera is gonna capture the best image at that setting. So next, let's talk about the aperture, or the f-stop as it's known. The aperture, or the f-stop, basically comes from the lens. It allows your lens to take in more light or less light, depending on how bright or how dark you want your scene to look. This is important because it also helps your ISO to stay at a lower setting or the native setting so that you can get the best quality image without that noise and that grain. Your aperture, or your f-stop, is determined based on the number on your lens. So the lowest aperture typically will be anywhere from 1.2 or 1.4. Now, the lower your aperture allows your camera to create bokeh effect, which you can see basically behind me with the little twinkling lights and the blurriness of the camera and the image. Now, the higher you set your aperture or your f-stop, the more sharper your image is gonna be and more in focus the background and the foreground are gonna be. You typically use a higher aperture or f-stop when you're outside or in a bright sunny day to kind of get everything nice and evenly lit. Whereas indoors, you typically use a lower f-stop or aperture so that you can allow as much natural light through the lens and into your camera sensor. So remember, the lower the aperture or f-stop, the more light you're letting into the lens, the higher the f-stop, the less light you're letting through the lens. Now that we understand what the ISO and the aperture or f-stop do for the camera, it's time to move on to the shutter speed. The shutter speed of the camera determines how much blurry motion you're gonna have in your footage, or how fast your footage is gonna be without any motion blur. And what I mean by that is, if I wave my hand back and forth, you see a little bit of blur. That's because my shutter speed right now is set to 48 degrees. However, I'm only shooting a tutorial video, so I don't need, you know, to make it look fast, and it's not high energy, high speed video. I'm not doing anything fast moving. So a 48 or a 50 degree shutter speed is fine for something like this. Again, it's all preference. You can do whatever you like. If you want to have a higher shutter speed, that's completely up to you. One thing you should note is that the higher your shutter speed, the darker your image becomes. That's because the light is taking a longer time to reach the sensor through the shutter of the camera to creating your image. The lower the shutter speed, the more motion blur you're gonna get, as I mentioned, and the more light you're gonna let in, because it's opening up longer so that the light can travel to your sensor. So I encourage you guys to go out there and shoot. I hope the video gave you a little bit more understanding of what the ISO, aperture, f-stop, and shutter speed do. Each camera has a different platform setting, so you kind of want to play around with your camera that you have and adjust each setting to something that you like. If you have any further questions, please leave a comment in the comment section down below, and I'll get back to you as quickly as possible. And stay tuned for the next video, where I discuss lighting and the importance of setting up light for your video.